Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 60th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1215.
One, ignition and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1095, then landed successfully for the first time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
A couple of days later on Friday, SpaceX successfully launched their 61st Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 11-6.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
Stage 1 propulsion is nominal.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the 18th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Then yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 62nd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 1222.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1069, then landed successfully for the 24th time on the drone ship A Shortfall of Gravitas.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
Related to the second landing we saw, SpaceX posted some information. They said Falcon lands for the 450th time. This coming week, we can hopefully expect to see a handful of Falcon launches. The first of these, the Starlink 17-1 mission, is currently scheduled for Tuesday 27th at 5:14 PM UTC or 1:14 PM EDT. The following day, and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1032 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 28th at 2:30 PM UTC or 10:30 AM EDT. A couple of days after that and we should see a customer mission launch. The GPS-37 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 30th at 6:23 PM UTC or 2:23 PM EDT. Later the same day and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 1118 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 30th at 9:24 PM UTC or 5:24 PM EDT. Heading to Boca Chica, there was more load testing seen being done with Pad B's chopstick arms. They also added more bags later and did some further load testing. Work has been continuing on the Pad B orbital launch mount. SpaceX were recently seen doing some testing with the orbital Pad A site. SpaceX was seen doing some tank farm testing recently as they prep for Flight 9. Work has been continuing on disassembling the high bay. SpaceX posted some information on when we can expect to see the Starship Flight 9 mission launch. They said the 9th flight test of Starship is preparing to launch as soon as Tuesday, May 27th. Regarding Elon Musk's update that he mentioned he would do, there was some information posted. It says Elon Musk will be providing a SpaceX company update live streamed on X on Tuesday, May 27th at 1 PM Eastern Time. Here's a look at B18.1 at Massey's insider testing structure. Starship 35 was recently seen moved to Massey's once again. Ship 35 later did a spin prime test as they near Flight 9. Ship 35 was then seen rolling back to the production site. This booster common dome section, likely for booster 18, was spotted moving in the yard. As SpaceX gets closer to the launch of Starship Flight 9, there are some dates on the Cameron County website to look at. They have possible closures currently for Tuesday 27th, Wednesday 28th and Thursday 29th. As always, I have to say thanks to Cesar Garcia, Jack Beyer, Gage Tellis and Jerry Pike for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.